Hi everyone, this is Daisy Margaret.
In this video, we are about to discuss Class 6, Term 2, Unit 2, Electricity, Part 1. Topics to be discussed in Part 1 are Introduction, Sources of Electricity, Thermal Power Stations, Hydel Power Stations, Atomic Power Stations and Windmills.
Introduction. We use electricity in our day-to-day life. Have you ever wondered from where do we get this electricity? How does this electricity work? Can we imagine a day without electricity? If you ask your grandfather, you can come to know a period without electricity. They used oil lamps for light, cooked on fires of wood or coal. By the advent of electricity, our day-to-day works are made easy and the world is on our hands. So if you ask your grandfather or grandmother, they can tell you because they would have lived in the world where the period was without electricity. So they used oil lamps instead of lights and they cooked on fires of wood instead of stove and they used wood or coal to cook their foods. By the invention of electricity, it made our works easier and in our day-to-day works, we use many things by the use of electricity. So the world is in our hands. Okay? So what are the appliances those work on electricity? What materials those allow electricity to flow through? What are electric circuits? What are electric cells and batteries? So we are going to discuss all these things in this lesson. So shall we move on to the lesson to know more about electricity? Can you list out the electrical appliances used in your home? Yes, we use iron box, we use electric kettle, light, fan, refrigerator, air conditioner. All these are some of the electrical appliances that you use in your home. First thing that we are going to discuss is about the sources of electricity. A small conversation is given in your textbook for you to know about the sources of electricity. So Selwyn and Selvi are twins. They are studying in 6th standard. They visited their grandparents' village during summer vacation. At 6 o'clock in the evening, Selwyn's grandfather switched on the light. The whole house was illuminated. The whole house was bright. Seeing this, Selwyn asked his grandfather, "How do we get light by switching on the switch?" So his grandfather took him to the nearest electricity board and inquired about the electricity. Let us look into the conversation. So the conversation is between Selwyn and engineer. He is asking the engineer, how do the electric bulb lighten up when we switch on the switch? The engineer answered, it is due to electricity. Now his question is, from where do we get this electricity? So the engineer answered, we get electricity from thermal power, hydel power, tidal power, wind power, solar power, etc. as sources of electricity. So Selwyn is asking, are these plants exist everywhere? The engineer is giving him the answer, no, these plants are constructed depending upon the natural resources available at that particular place. For example, we have thermal power plant in Neyveli, Tamil Nadu, as lignite is available there. So Selwyn is saying, yes, I have seen the windmills near the hills of Tirunelveli district, which has potential wind resource. Thank you, sir, for this valuable information. He says, "Thank you, sir, for your valuable information." So this is a small conversation that is discussed in your book, discussing about the sources of electricity. So what are sources of electricity? The sources of electricity are thermal power stations, hydel power stations, atomic power stations, windmills. Before learning about all these things, what is electricity? Electricity is the presence and flow of electric charge. Where do we get electricity from? Electricity is a form of energy that we get when we convert other forms of energies like thermal energy, kinetic energy, solar energy, chemical energy, and so on. So that one is called as electricity. It is a form of energy that we get when we convert the other forms of energies. What is sources of electricity? Any device from which electricity is produced is called the source of electricity. So any device that is producing electricity, okay, so from which the electricity is produced, that is called as source of electricity. Okay, so we have many sources of electricity. You can see here solar cells, windmills, atomic power stations, thermal power stations, hydel power stations. These are some of the sources of electricity. We get electricity from different sources. The major electric power stations in Tamil Nadu are, so we have given the major electric power stations in Tamil Nadu: thermal stations, Neyveli in Kadalur district, Yennur in Tiruvallur district; hydel power stations, Mettur in Salem district, Papanasam in Tirunelveli district; atomic power stations, Kalpakkam in Kanchipuram district, Kudangulam in Tirunelveli district; windmills, Aralvai Mozhi in Kanyakumari district,
Kayathaaru in Tirunelveli district.
So thermal stations, they are something which is related to heat. Thermal is related to heat. Hydel power stations, hydel, it is the force given by the fast running water. Atomic power stations, atomic energy is energy released through a nuclear reaction. Windmills, so that is a machine operated by wind. Apart from these, solar panels, which are prevalent in many places, are used to produce electricity. What is a solar panel? Solar panel, it is a device used to absorb sun's rays and they will convert them into electricity or heat. So solar panels are actually collection of solar cells which can be used to generate electricity. So these are the different sources of electricity. Let us discuss each and every one in detail. Thermal power stations. In thermal power stations, the thermal energy is generated by burning coal, diesel or gas is used to produce steam. The steam thus produced is used to rotate the turbine. So already I told you, thermal is something which is relating to heat. So these thermal power stations, the thermal energy is generated. Okay, the thermal energy is generated by burning the coal, diesel or gas. So while burning this coal, diesel or gas, they will be producing steam. That steam is produced and that steam is used to rotate the turbine. What is turbine? Turbine, it is a machine for producing continuous power in which a wheel or blade is typically fitted. It is made to revolve by fast moving flow of water, steam, gas, air or other fluid. The steam produced from the coal, diesel or gas, whichever is burned. So the steam is only used to rotate this turbine. So you can see here, this is the picture of turbine. So while this turbine rotates, the coil of wire kept between the electromagnet rotates. Due to the electromagnetic induction, the electricity is produced. So thus the heat energy is converted into electrical energy. So you can see here in this picture, we are burning the coal and that burning of coal is producing steam, and that steam, it is going into the turbine. So you can see here, we are burning the coal and the steam, it is getting traveled, and here we have the turbine. So that turbine will be rotated and we have the electromagnet here. So while the turbine rotates, the coil of the wire which is kept between the electromagnet also rotates. So due to the electromagnetic induction, the electricity is produced. Thus, in thermal power stations, the heat energy is converted into electrical energy. Hydel power stations. Here it is based on the force of the flow of water. So Hydel power stations. In Hydel power stations, the turbine is made to rotate by the flow of water from dams to produce electricity. So what is Hydel power stations? In that, the turbine will be made to rotate by the flow of water. The flow of water from the dams, they will be rotating the turbine. Due to the force of flow of water, the turbine will rotate, and because of the rotation of the turbine, the electricity will be produced. So here the kinetic energy is converted into electrical energy.
hydel stations have long economic lives and low operating cost.
So what is done in hydel power stations? The kinetic energy is converted into electrical energy, and this is very, very economic and it is low operating cost. Atomic power stations. In atomic power stations, nuclear energy is used to boil water. The steam thus produced is used to rotate the turbine. As a result, electricity is produced. What is atomic power? Atomic power or atomic energy, it is the energy released through a nuclear reaction. So this atomic power stations, the nuclear energy is only used to boil the water. So when we boil the water, the steam thus produced only is used to rotate the turbine. So as you produce the steam by using the nuclear energy, okay, you are using nuclear energy to boil the water, and the steam from that is produced and it is used to rotate the turbine. So as the result, the electricity is produced. The steam will rotate the turbine and thus the electricity will be produced. Atomic power stations are also called nuclear power stations. What are atomic power stations are also called as? They are also called as nuclear power stations. Here, nuclear energy is converted into mechanical energy and then electrical energy. So what happens? First, the nuclear energy, it is converted into mechanical energy and then it is converted into electrical energy. Windmills. In windmills, wind energy is used to rotate the turbine to produce electricity. Here, kinetic energy is converted into electrical energy. What is a windmill? Windmill, it is a machine with rotating blades. Okay, it is a machine with rotating blades, or it is a device that is used to convert the wind energy into electrical energy. What are windmills? Windmills, they are the machine operated by wind so that the electrical energy will be produced. So in windmills, the wind energy only is used, and the wind energy only is rotating the turbine. So wind energy, they will rotate the turbine and thus the electricity will be produced. So in windmills, the kinetic energy is converted into the electrical energy. So these are the four different sources of electricity. Let me ask you a few questions from whatever we have learned. Try to answer. What are the sources of electricity? Summary of the video. We discussed about introduction and we mainly discussed about the sources of electricity: thermal power stations, hydel power stations, atomic power stations and windmills. This is to be continued. If you like the video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching.